Hello guys, John Scott here for WrestleLearn, and I'm pleased to say on the line in these odd times. I keep saying that every time I have somebody new on, but it is a strange time in amongst the pandemic and stuff like that. But I'm really pleased to say, joining me on the line, Adam Maxted. And how are you doing, Adam?
I'm all good, John, thank you. Yeah, it's a weird time we're living in, but you know, I think what makes it easier is like everyone's going through it at the same time. So it's not like, you know, although people might be depressed or feeling down and stuff, at least they have some comfort in knowing that everyone's going through the same thing, and it's not just you and stuff. So just trying to stay positive. You know, my biggest problem is I need a haircut. That's the thing that's driving me nuts. Because I usually have a nice sweet fade like every week. I go to the Turkish barbers and get sorted out. And honestly, I'm looking like Jimmy Neutron or something at the moment. So yeah, but all good. Touch wood, feeling good. And I've got some weights in the house and stuff, so I'm, you know, trying to maintain my physique and my shape and stuff. And, you know, I said on Twitter the other day, I was like, I'll never complain about paying into Pure Gym again, like 7 or 8 quid for a single day session. I'll never complain again, you know, I'll never take that for granted again. So, but yeah.
Yes, it's an odd thing. Like this whole thing, like, I have a lot of listeners that message me, and the main theme is that they're always bored. But, you know, I keep saying to everybody, look, they're not kind of asking us to go to war. You know, It is literally just about sitting indoors. And I know that for a lot of people is a bit of an inconvenience. But again, my hat's off to all the people that are out there doing the jobs, the carers, the NHS, shopkeepers, you know, keeping it going. It could be one of those. So in a way, it's kind of like we're fortunate that we're just sitting at home.
But absolutely.
I guess it's that whole, I think it's the unexpectancy of like how long is it all going to be and that kind of thing.
I think if we had like a deadline, then we'd be like, right, okay, look, we just got to get through until this point. But because we don't know, it's kind of like every day, it just seems to get frustrating and stuff. But like you say, there's people out there that are literally like having to be on the front line and looking after people. And like I'm literally sat at home playing Call of Duty, waking up when I want to, watching whatever wrestling I want, and then like working out. And you know, so I can't complain. But I mean, to anyone listening, I feel like there's no better time to, you know, use this time to be productive and, you know, use it to the best of your ability, because, you know, one day we're going to be back to our routine and back to work, and, you know, just use the time as much as you can, you know, to try and be productive.
Now, obviously, we met, like, I mean, it seems ages ago now.
Yeah, I know, but it probably wasn't that long ago, but yeah.
No, but it was in January, and I think I was there for the, like, the kickoff of the All-Star Tour that year, and I saw you there. Obviously, you'd been working quite a bit for them in that period. And I actually had Mariah May on just recently as well, and she was talking about it, because obviously they do run a hell of a lot of shows. And obviously, you've gone from one extreme to the other in terms of you know, being out on the road and stuff. You mentioned about having weights and stuff like that in the house. Is that as a wrestler? I mean, it's got to be a bit difficult to want to get out there and obviously get the practice in the ring as such.
Yeah, like my body feels great because I'm not bumping around and stuff. Do you know what I mean? I've touched wood. I have no niggles, no pains, no nothing. But I kind of miss that, like that stiff feeling, and you know, waking up with a stiff neck and stuff. Like I miss that just because it just comes with the job. Do you know what I mean? But I think it's, you know, to any wrestlers or stuff out there that might be listening to this, like it's probably, if they had an injury or they had like something that was giving them a bit of bother, it's probably been incredible that like this has kind of happened, because they are getting the time to like rehab and rest their body and stuff. And like, hopefully then whenever this is over, then, you know, everyone's back feeling good, feeling healthy and like ready to smash it again. And, you know, I think like obviously the British wrestling scene is as booming and as amazing as it is, that, you know, I've heard some stuff online that people were like, oh, this is going to like really affect British wrestling. But I think that there's so much passion for wrestling in the UK, and there's so many, you know, motivated and passionate people that are running shows, and so much the talent pool as well. Like obviously NXT, like people were worried that they were going to take like all the talent stuff, and obviously they've taken a lot of the best talent, but it's been an opportunity for a lot of people to step up and like start making a name for themselves, and like they have been doing that. And you know, like I say, I think once stuff goes back to normal, it will just kind of pick up where we left off, and the scene will be just as hot as ever, you know.
Yeah, no, I agree. It's kind of it's a common theme. Like a lot of people, especially when NXT UK come on the scene, were like really concerned. Eyebrows were being raised, and this was going to be the death of the UK wrestling industry. But to be honest with you, like from my point of view, being out on the road and working press at many shows, I was having to pick between like five every weekend. I mean, I've never seen so many.
Yeah, absolutely.
To choose from, and like really professionally run. That's the big difference, I would say. I think like maybe 10, 15 years ago, I mentioned this on a podcast the other day, but I remember going to a show and it was, there was no ring. It was a gym mat and two guys that I felt like I could take in a fight. And that was it. Whereas today, everything is so well done, so well produced.
Absolutely.
Most of it's being recorded now as well.
I think if you look at, like, for me, it's like, if you look at NGW that obviously do Butlins, they obviously do like Hull City Hall as well. And like the production that they do there, like they have like a massive lighting ring and stuff. And even places I've been recently, like TNT in Liverpool, like their production, they've got the big LED screen, like big league wrestling down in like Yeovil and stuff. They've also, they've got this massive like big LED screen. Like there's so much, I feel like a lot of those people that obviously work on just the ring crew, they don't get enough credit as well. Like, you know, as wrestlers, you kind of come in and the ring's already up and you're just backstage and then you kind of, you're leaving the venue and there's still guys that are there, you know, taking down like lighting and wires. And, you know, shout out to all those guys, because you kind of can take it for granted that, you know, it's like, oh, well, you know, it's just their job or they're getting paid, but it's actually, you know, it's a tough job for them as well. And, you know, just, I'm sure everyone's enjoying a little break, but I'm sure we're all hoping that it doesn't last too long and we can all get back at it, you know?
Absolutely. Now, I've got to be honest with you, your name, I would say out of everybody's, gets mentioned the most, that you've got the most potential at the moment. Everyone's saying it's not going to be long. You're going to get like a major call up. Obviously, you are you. And, you know, no one else can answer that other than yourself. But I mean, in terms of setting goals, and I know we spoke about briefly last time, but like, have you got somewhere or like a main sort of aim where you'd like to finish up or try or have that experience? Or are you just pretty much growing and taking it day by day?
I'm always like growing, and I want to, you know, I see every chance I step in the ring is like a chance to, I feel like I still have something to prove every time I get in the ring, because of my reality TV background. There are still a lot of UK wrestling fans that might not have seen me live, like in action, and to them it's like, oh, Adam Maxted, he's just this TV guy. And so I kind of, not that I've got like a chip on my shoulder, but it's like every time I lace in my boots and I go out there, it's like, right, there could be, even if it's just one guy or one person, it's like they might not have seen me before and they might have that attitude or that opinion that I'm just that TV guy. So at least if I can show like, oh, okay, shit, like he's got a lot of potential, or, you know, he's making good improvements, which I like through my hard work the past like year or so, I have, I feel like I have, like I've started to, because I was worried I was going to be kind of put in like the, oh, he's just the camp sort of Butland style wrestler, you know, right, with the kids and families. Yeah, yeah. And, you know, thanks to places like ICW and like OTT in Ireland, like they've given me some big matches, like against like Pete Dunne and Pac and like Mark Haskins and like top indie guys that are obviously known around the world. And like, I've had good matches with them and I've held my own, and it's kind of showing people like, okay, he's not just that kind of style. But in terms of goals, definitely a couple of years ago, it was like WWE. And like, I'll be honest, like it still is. WWE is still my big goal, but I kind of, I'm not in a rush anymore. Like when I did a tryout in 2017, at the start of 2017, and there was guys on my tryout that were like, oh, Adam, you know, if anyone is going to get signed to Orlando, like the performance center, it's going to be you, because you're not that experienced and like you look how you look and you're athletic, and they're probably going to see like all the potential you've got. And so in my head, like not going in, like I wasn't going in like I've got this, but it was kind of like, oh, you know, this could be the big chance. And then obviously it didn't happen, and I was kind of bummed down a little bit, not for too long. Like I picked myself, I was kind of like, you know what, I'll just go out there and make a name for myself. And I don't know whether it was like WWE want to see like, is this guy just thinking he can come in from a TV show and like get it all handed to him just because he's like well known in UK, or does he actually want this? And I guess like looking back now, I'm kind of glad that it's happened the way it's happened, because I've had to go out there, I've had to work hard, I've had to keep, and like I wasn't ready back then. Obviously I would have been ready for like a developmental deal, but when I came off the TV show, I wasn't, like the matches, there were some matches I was getting put in and some shows that I was on that I like had no right to be on, you know what I mean? There's guys wrestling like 10, 15 years that were shows, and then I just was in. But obviously I would sell tickets, you know, because of the whole Love Island thing, and then I was getting experience, and that's the whole reason why I did the TV show, was to like get my name out there. So again, I wouldn't change that. Like looking back, I don't see it as a negative thing, although I was thrown into the deep end and I probably stood out like, oh, this guy's green still, or he's not experienced. I still wouldn't like change the way I've done things, you know? So, but Yeah, WWE still my goal, definitely. I think unless you've been there and had a bad experience, then most wrestlers, if they're being truly honest, it's like, why would you not want to wrestle for the biggest company in the world? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It'd be like a kid that plays football saying that he doesn't want to play for his favorite like team. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, that still is the goal. And you know, there has been some contact with them and stuff. You know, especially this year. And you know, so you know, we'll see kind of what happens if once everything goes back to normal and, you know, possibly towards the end of the year, you never know.
Mm-hmm.
So things are positive. Put it this way, like I'm happy in the situation that I'm in. Like,
yeah, that's
I know that there's contact there and stuff, and they know who I am, and there's some interest and stuff. So,
and you touched on it briefly then. I was going to ask about that, like whether in hindsight how you felt about that. But I mean, you answered it pretty much yourself there about the whole Love Island TV show and whether it became more of a burden after doing it, or obviously you said you wanted to do it to get more exposure. I mean, after all that, do you feel like it helped you more, or did you think that, like, in terms of you, like, cause obviously you are going to get picked for certain matches, you are going to be like the go-to name on top of the poster because you're going to be able to sell those tickets, but was that more pressure on you, like the wrong kind of pressure, or did you think that that kind of paid off in the end, and like over time it's leveled out just right?
I think that's a good way of putting it, like leveling out, because mm-hmm. like when I was back in Ireland, I always knew that I was gonna eventually like break into the UK like kind of wrestling scene. I knew it would mm-hmm. just take obviously like time, and obviously with the exposure of OTT and stuff, because you look at like guys like More Than Hype and Scotty Davis and people like that, they're like pretty much flying over to the UK every week from Ireland mm-hmm. to do shows. So I kind of believed in myself and knew that that would eventually happen. But with like doing the TV show, it just sped everything up kind of.
Yeah.
And like I touched on there a bit, like I probably wasn't ready for the stuff that I was getting, but it was kind of like right, sink or swim. And mm-hmm. the fact that like 3 years on from all that, it's like now I'm kind of one of the busiest guys in the UK, and like one of the names that would probably be like most people know my name now, kind of. It kind of shows that like I kind of didn't just ride the wave of the TV show, and then mm-hmm. within 6 months I was like, oh okay, I haven't made it, or this is old news. Or if promoters thought like, oh, we're not making any money from using him on posters anymore, there's no point mm-hmm. having him on the show, then we'll not use him anymore. But those promoters and those shows have still like believed in me and have like saw the potential that I have, and I'm kind of changing people's opinions of me now, kind of, like I say, every time I step in the ring now. So
I definitely think that. And lastly, about Love Island, when you obviously knew you was going on the show with how you were going to come out of this, did you kind of go in half thinking, I'm gonna play, I could really start a character here and then play and spin off on it later when I get out, or was that never thinking at all? You're just gonna be you.
Yeah, I don't think I thought that much into it. I kind of to be honest, I haven't watched any of my stuff. I've seen the odd clip and stuff. I haven't actually sat down and watched my series and stuff. But
really,
I really didn't come across like the true me, if that makes sense. I have a lot more personality, and like I'm a lot funnier than I came across on that show. Mm-hmm. But I guess for me, I was like, right, okay, if WWE kind of see any of this or are watching any of this, mm-hmm. or they, you know, like I don't want to be seen like being vulgar or like swearing or like mm-hmm. doing like stuff on TV with girls and things that could then one day jeopardize, like if you type in on YouTube, like Adam, like if, you know, anything could have come up on YouTube, and like mm-hmm. I didn't want to jeopardize like my future by going mm-hmm. on there and being silly and trying to be like Jack the Lad and stuff. So it was kind of like, there was already, obviously I came into the show later as well, so there was already people in there that had big personalities and stuff. So I just didn't want to come in and start trying to be like, hey, look at me, kind of. So I definitely didn't fully come across, like, you know, if you ask my close friends in wrestling now how, like, random and spontaneous and, like, things I do in public, like, just for the crack and just for laughs, like, they'll tell you. But I just kind of went in there and was like, I'll just kind of keep my head down, just be the nice guy and just get through it, and hopefully it'll help with wrestling. And, you know, but again, I wouldn't change that. I wouldn't change how I came across. You know, when people truly get to know me and stuff, especially in wrestling, they know how funny I am. And, you know, again, in the future, if I was somewhere like at WWE or something, you know, when it comes to doing promos and things, like, they'll eventually see that side of me, you know, once I get comfortable and stuff.
Mm-hmm. I've got to ask, like, a lot of people were huffing and puffing about it, but WrestleMania, did you sit down and watch it? And what was that experience
I absolutely did. Because again, like, I'm just a huge fan of wrestling in general. You know what I mean? I watch everything. it's funny because sometimes I'll be traveling in cars with like wrestlers and stuff, and they'll be like, oh, I haven't watched wrestling in like 3 or 4 years, and it's like, but you're on your way to wrestle on a show now.
It's like, very common, like, I think. I hear that a lot. That's very common.
And maybe I just haven't like been battered by the job yet.